Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, it's my privilege and honor to introduce to you Edsel Ford High School graduating class of 2011. Yeah. Audience, please rise for our national anthem to be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance to be led by Scott Worth. First, our national anthem. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. The great painter Vincent van Gogh once said, "I dream my paintings, then I paint my dreams." Graduating class of 2011, the road to success is full of dreams and aspirations. It's built on vision, dedication, and hard work. Our celebration this evening is a testimonial to your hard work and dedication. However, this is only a pit stop along your new journey in life. Maximize your potential by making your dreams a reality. Seek new knowledge and never waver on your quest for excellence. Our world is rapidly changing. Technological advancements make it all possible to attain instantaneous information and access to unthinkable formats with a touch of a button on a cell phone, a computer, or an iPod. Graduates, you have been labeled as the generation of why not. You are by far the first generation to engage in a far superior social and technological change in the history of mankind. You're positioned to lead us in this new environment if you constantly paint your dreams and make them a reality. To our graduating class, we say you've been a wonderful class. To our parents, staff, we say thank you, for without you, and without your dedication, love, support, and understanding, none of this would have been possible. Graduation seniors, what awaits you is an exciting world full of limitless possibilities. In the words of the late First Lady, Eleanor Roosevelt, and I quote, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." Class of 2011, always dream the dream of success and achievement. Best shot at what life brings your way. Good luck and best wishes. Edsel Ford High School is blessed to have so many friends and supporters. Please allow me to introduce to you our honored guests and staff on the main stage behind me. I would like to ask you please to hold your applause until I finish with my introductions. First, we are honored to have with us Mr. James Schoolmaster, President of the Dearborn Board of Education. Next, Mrs. Mary Plitchikoff, Vice President of the Dearborn Board of Education. Mrs. Amy Blackburn, Trustee, Board of Education, and an Edsel Ford parent. Ms. Pam Adams, Treasurer, Dearborn Board of Education, and Edsel Ford graduates. Ms. Mary Lane, Trustee of Board of Education, and also an Edsel Ford parent. Mr. Hussein Berry, Trustee of the Board of Education, and Edsel Ford friend. Mrs. Zainab Ali, President of our Edsel Ford PTSA. Mrs. Ali, thank you for your dedication and commitment to the Edsel community. Brian Whiston, superintendent of Dearborn Public Schools, Dr. Gail Shankman, associate superintendent of Dearborn Public Schools, Dr. Kathy Klee, coordinator of assessment for Dearborn Public Schools, Ms. Sue Noland, assistant principal, Mr. Dan Blessing, assistant principal, Mrs. Janice Schmidt, literacy coordinator, our counselors, Ms. Robin Armstrong, Mrs. Gail Welmers, Mr. Greg Kiefer, and Mr. Abraham Baidun. We are honored to have with us the following staff members and teachers: Ms. Lisa Lark, Ms. Julie Weingartner, Mr. Jack Shankman, Dr. Rakat Araf, Barbara McAuliffe, Ms. Bridget Brozjak, Mrs. Tina James, Mrs. Lori O'Brien, Mr. Joe Cook, and Senora Margarita Chavez Franco. I hope I did not miss anybody. Thank you. Also, we have a few teachers who are helping and staff members: Mr. Picano, Mr. Bacchus, Ms. Barbat, Ms. Redinger, Ms. Bauman, Mrs. Moselov, Mrs. Sorgan, Mr. Ali, and Mr. DeClalla helping us with this event. We thank them as well. Our first speaker is a dedicated student advocate and a proud Edsel Ford parent. Her passion for school transformation continues to shape the future of our district. Speaking on behalf of Dearborn Board of Education, please help me welcome Mrs. Mary Lane.
Seniors and everyone else, good evening and greetings. On behalf of the Dearborn Board of Education and the citizens of the cities of Dearborn and Dearborn Heights, I come to express our sincere pride and congratulations to the graduating class of 2011 of Edsel Ford High School. Graduation day is the best day in the life of a school district, and it's a great day to graduate. Graduates of the class of 2011, we celebrate your accomplishment of 13 years of learning to become an educated citizen in a modern society. Your families and friends had nurtured you day in and day out. The community has invested more than $100,000 in public funds in your education. Now, graduation marks the end of the road of childhood. You are prepared to start along life's path. Class of 2011, welcome to the world of adulthood and responsibility. Yeah. Your high school diploma is the starting line in your next life journey. However, this educational achievement must be combined in the future with continued hard work and your own investment in your education and training, in order for you to have a future of good jobs, fulfillment, and respect. From now, I hope you will treasure and recall this feeling of pride, deserved celebration, and success at this graduation. Families and friends, you too deserve acclaim for the support of today's graduates. Like the graduates, today is the public culmination of your support and your constancy. You too have earned a piece of these high school diplomas, and we hope you take great pleasure in them. Finally, we must salute all the staff of Dearborn Public Schools who brought these graduates to this day by the dedication to education. Please personally thank your teachers, lunch ladies, security guards, principals, and everyone else in now and in the future. Remember to come back and visit, stay in touch, and tell us of your future successes. Go forward, class of 2011, with our love, make us proud, and live happy, productive lives. Very best wishes to all of you.
Our superintendent of schools, Mr. Brian Whiston, is our next speaker. Mr. Whiston continues to extend a litany of initiatives supporting Edsel Ford High School, which have positively impacted our student achievement here at Edsel Ford. Mr. Whiston.
Thank you. To our graduates, on behalf of the administration and Board of Education, I offer our congratulations to you for what you've done over the last 13 years to get to this day. It's also a time of reflection, and I'd like to reflect back for the parents on how fast the 13 years have gone by, but want to thank you for your love and support in helping these students be successful. So if we could have parents stand so your students can congratulate you, I'd appreciate that. Parents, please stand. Students, please thank your parents for their efforts helping you get here today. Thank you. Also, as we reflect over the last 13 years, you've had teachers and other school personnel, including administrators, who have made a difference in your lives. So could we all have all teachers and administrators in the audience and stage and elsewhere stand and be recognized for their efforts to help the students be successful?
Get up.
It's also time to celebrate. As you celebrate today and dream about your tomorrows, have fun and enjoy, but of course not too much fun, because we need each and every one of you to be around to make a difference in the Dearborn community and the larger community. Being part of Dearborn Schools has come to an end. You've earned the right to graduate and take your rightful place in college and work or in the community. So thank you for sharing yourself with us and helping all of us be better, because you were part of the Dearborn Schools. Students, remember what you've learned, remember the relationships you've built, be proud of the Dearborn community, and give back to it as it has given you so much. Dream your dreams and help them become true because of your efforts. I'd like to leave you with a quote: when once you have tasted flight, you will forever walk the earth with your eyes turned skyward, for there you have been, and there you will long to return, from Leonardo da Vinci. This is a great metaphor for achieving success, attaining goals, and the inner drive that will keep you achieving again and again. So like a thunderbird, soar into your future, looking skyward, believing in yourself that you can accomplish anything you set your heart and mind to. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Whiston. Every year, a graduating senior is chosen to deliver the student address. I am proud to present to you Scott Worth, who is the class president of 2011, to be addressing our assembly this evening. Scott?
To my beloved friends and colleagues of the class of 2011, Martin Luther King Jr. once penned these words: "The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy." I find that to be very true. Throughout the years, the class of 2011 has been through challenges and controversies. But like the confident Thunderbirds that we are, we always picked ourselves up with no hesitation, time and time again. Edsel Ford is one of the most unique schools in the country. We pride ourselves in being what we like to call unique, but united. And we are just that. Edsel Ford High School is blessed with the opportunities to embrace different worldly cultures on a day-to-day basis. These opportunities set Edsel apart from all other schools in the country. When we go off to college, the armed forces, the workplace, or wherever our futures may take us, we will always have that worldly perspective that can only be discovered within the hallways of Edsel Ford High School. That perspective is what sets us apart. That's what makes us unique but united. The fact that Edsel Ford, and more specifically the class of 2011, is so colorblind to the differences that they see in their peers makes us a great example for the world to follow. The supportive staff, comfortable atmosphere, caring peers are other examples as to why Edsel is unique in the way it educates an individual as a whole. Whether it's the teachers that stay after school to give help to those who need it, the student leaders giving up their vulnerable time to help others, the principal always willing to lend a hand to those who need it, or the counselors who will listen to anyone who needs a friend to talk to. We are a family. We are Edsel Ford. I want to take a moment and thank an individual very dear to my heart who has helped mold us into the people who we are today. This man has been there for some of us since the beginning of sixth grade. I like to call him our Mr. Feeny, like from the hit TV show Boy Meets World. His kind heart and passion for students have been inspiring to us all. Leadership and optimism have been a great example for us to follow throughout high school. Our principal, Mr. Jafer, I would like to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being the solid rock foundation for the growth of all of your students throughout your career. As cliche as this may sound, today marks a new chapter in our lives, a new turning point in our story. We may venture down different paths, travel different places, experience different things. We are all united by one thing, the road that led us to this point. Many times that road was filled with difficulty, easiness, laughter, sorrow, sadness, happiness, bad times, and good times. I encourage all of you to use what you've learned here at Edsel Ford and apply it to whatever you do. Leave this place as a proud Thunderbird and truly change this world. Friends, it's been my pleasure to walk with you step by step through this amazing journey that we call life. On a final note, I want to thank all of you. From the bottom of my heart, I've truly been honored to serve you as the president of the class of 2011. I hope that the time you spent here at Edsel Ford has been rewarding. It has for me. It is my hope that you walk across the stage today with the strength and confidence you need to take on the world. But in your future endeavors, I hope that Edsel Ford will always have a place in your heart. This isn't goodbye, but until next time. Congratulations, class of 2011. I wish you all the best of luck. God bless you. We did it.
Nice job, Scott. Thank you, Scott. It's a beautiful, warm evening tonight. And I'm certain we will all enjoy now a very special presentation, musical presentation, by our Edsel Ford band, led by Mr. Greg Guzzard. Maestro? Each year, the faculty at Edsel Ford High School recognizes the two top academic students at our building, the valedictorian and the salutatorian. Exemplify hard work, unparalleled focus, and superior academic achievement. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great honor that I present to you our 2011 Edsel Ford valedictorian, Chad Westra. Chad, please stand up. Stay there. And our salutatorian, Mohammed Saleh. Mohammed, please stand up. Before I ask our salutatorian, Mohammed, to step forward and address
our assembly, I would like to say a few words about him. Mohammed has accumulated an impressive GPA of 4.10. Mohammed will be attending University of Michigan Ann Arbor and majoring in biochemistry. He also would like to major in Islamic studies. His career goal is to become a pediatrician. Mohammed enjoys volunteering at Oakwood Hospital and the Salina Community Center. He also tutors students in his spare time, free of charge, I must say. He also enjoys the recital of the Quran. Mohammed attended Al-Watan School in Yemen and Salina Intermediate starting in seventh grade. He started his career in Durham Public Schools as an English language learner. Quite an achievement, is it not? I would like to ask Mr. Dan Blessing to help in the presentation of the salutatorian medallion. Help me recognize Muhammad's father, Mr. Saad, who's taking pictures right here, and his younger brother, Al-Masri. Muhammad, step forward, please. You can hug him. Give him a kiss. Hold him up. Hold him up for a
second. Oh, there's a moment. There's a moment.
Take a picture over there.
Okay, Mohammed.
The speech.
Good evening, Mr. Jaffer, Ms. Nolan, Mr. Blessing, Ms. Walmers, teachers and staff, families and guests, and foremost, my fellow classmates. Congratulations to the class of 2011. It is an honor for me to stand in front of you today and entertain you with a couple of words. As seniors, we have reached a milestone in our lives, accomplishing our roles as high school students and overcoming many obstacles on the way. When we graduate, we are expected to follow the norm, go to college, get a degree, and for some of us, start a career and possibly a family. This is what most of us are expected to do. I don't want to bore you with the same stuff, even though they are necessary for our success and life in the near future. I can remember how silly many of us were when it came to doing our work. We would wait till the last second, rush the work, do it and get it over with, just to get the grade. You know, there's a scenario I could be saying right now. You know, it's part of Ms. James. I think she knows it very well. Ms. James, I forgot to do my homework. Can I turn it in tomorrow? I was busy over the weekend. Please, Ms. James. And Ms. James will reply, as she always does, "You know that I told you I would never accept late homework. There are no excuses. It was due today and I won't give you a chance. I don't care about your laziness. You'll get a zero on the assignment." And a conversation hidden though, and while passing, "All I care about in language arts is to pass with a D minus. Who cares? I just want to graduate." These scenarios are ones I saw most often in the hallways throughout my entire career. You know that often there are no second or third chances in life, and we must get past expecting to get by. Our future depends on how we plan steps to achieve success. If you think a D minus will get you somewhere, try it. As I look back on my high school days, I realized that all a person had to do is work a little bit harder, and he will achieve the goals he wants to achieve, and the good grades will follow. For me, an A minus was never enough. I was the type that liked solid A's. Ask my teachers, I would fight for half a point. And many of you may recall this, and start laughing. But you know, a half point makes a difference. It could raise you from an A minus to an A. And that's what most of us want. It took great time and effort for me to stand in front of you today. I know that every person has certain abilities and strength, and we must use them to the fullest. Not all of us will be doctors, scientists, or engineers, but what matters the most is that we have a productive place in our society. Keep your dreams high, classmates of 2011, and you'll achieve your goals. Even if you fail in your first attempts, do not stop. because you will succeed at the end.
What? My time is almost over, and I still have never given thanks to those that need to be thanked. Well, I have to thank all the parents in front of me today and guardians for setting the stage for us to stand in front of you today, graduates of the class of 2011. I give great thanks to my parents for their support and love. I always remember every day that they gave me lectures and advices on how I should be responsible and how they wanted me to be successful in the future. Even my little brother, Amasri, he gave me a lot of headache, you know. No. I thank him for making me do my homework in the dark night when he was asleep, which made me feel the struggle of dealing with little sleep. You might wonder why and how. He never let me touch a pen or the computer without him sitting on my lap and touching them first. I remember when I would try to sit on the computer chair, he would come and sit on my lap and start playing with the keyboard, not letting me do any essay. So I wait until he goes to sleep and then do my homework. But enough with personal stories. I know that all of us will miss the school in one way or another, but the most important thing that we should do is to thank the teachers and staff and faculty members that helped us and gave us another step to achieve this achievement and successful for the near future. And may Allah help us all, God Almighty, to accomplish our goals. Go class of 2011 and go.
Yeah. We're proud of you, Muhammad, and proud of your accomplishments. Our class of 2011 valedictorian, Chad Westra, has accumulated an outstanding GPA of 4.20. And some change, I should add. He plans on attending Calvin College and pursue a degree in history. His career goal is to become a teacher. He thrives on community service. Yeah, I see he has a fan club behind me right here. He thrives on community service and helping the underprivileged. He's very active in his church, youth group, and Bible studies. He's a good tennis player who shows no mercy on his serve. He also enjoys ultimate frisbee and other sports. Chad attended Dearborn Christian School for his elementary and middle school years. I would like to recognize Chad's parents, Doug and Beth Westra. Sister Kara, where are you? Right there. Grandparents Larry and Marge Westra, grandparents Art at Cornelia College, Aunts Lisa Westra, Roxanne Ziduna, and cousin Carrie. Congratulations. Chad, please come forward to receive your medallion, which will be presented to you by Miss Noland. Miss Noland?
Congratulations.
Thank
what a
you.
Great accomplishment.
Oh, back over.
Yes, it goes very gingerly.
With a smile.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'd like to start out by thanking you all for being here, parents, relatives, and teachers, and other staff members, and for allowing me this great opportunity to speak. I'd also like to say congratulations to my fellow students. But before I address the graduates, I'd like to give proper thanks to all those who've helped us to reach this point. First, I give thanks to God, who's made all of this possible. To our parents, thank you for all the countless support you've given us. I can't even begin to name all of the examples of your help. Next, to the teachers, it certainly takes skill to make come alive a boring lecture on government or to keep us awake in math class. But we want to thank you for all of your hard work and for putting up with us these 4 years. Finally, to Mr. Jaffer and the rest of the staff here, thank you for inspiring us each day and instilling in us the belief that we could succeed. Now I'd like to turn my attention towards my graduates, my fellow classmates. There's no lying that we all feel ready to be done. This ceremony may just be one final roadblock on the path to summer, but someday you'll look back and remember this day with pride. I want to reflect on our journey as a class and offer some advice as we go on from Edsel Ford. You may remember, as I do, walking into this huge school as a freshman, feeling small and a little bit lost. Not knowing what to do, we learned to look to the older students as examples to follow. They were the leaders of the school. They were the ones taking calculus. They were the sports captains, the link crew leaders, and the drum majors in marching band. And it was from their example that we learned to survive in Edsel Ford. As sophomores, we were growing accustomed to Edsel and were slowly learning how to be leaders. We left the upstairs freshman academy and had to survive on our own. We took on new challenges and were given new opportunities, such as taking advanced classes like AP Chemistry and AP US History, some of the hardest classes a high schooler could take. Then as juniors, all of a sudden, the roles had reversed on us. We were the older kids to the new freshmen. We were the ones being looked up to. We were becoming the link crew leaders, the ones taking calculus, and the ones leading our sports teams. Yet we still had the seniors above us. We still had their example to follow and them to fall back on. And as junior year flew by and summer came, now we were expected to be leaders as seniors. We were the ones to guide the school. I don't even think we knew what that meant or were aware that that was our duty. But I can tell you that it was a natural transformation for us. This is because it was ingrained in us from day one, from the moment we stepped into Edsel Ford. In every aspect, from the example of the upperclassmen, to the teachers and coaches, to the frequent words from Mr. Jaffer challenging us and inspiring us, we were ready and prepared to be leaders. From coordinating blood drives, to editing the school newspaper, to taking the lead in the musical, to being a positive role model to the underclassmen, we were the leaders. And now, my fellow graduates, I challenge you to be leaders in the next phase of your lives. Like freshmen 4 years ago, we will again find ourselves in uncharted waters, in places we're not familiar with. We'll face new challenges, new obstacles, and new roadblocks, but we'll be taking with us the experiences we've had here and the spirit of leadership that we've learned. We're ready and prepared. So go out and be leaders in whatever situation you find yourself in, whether that's at your college, at your job, or in your home, be a leader. In this way, go out and make a difference, impact the world. Again, thank you for letting me speak, and congratulations, class of 2011.
Very nicely done, Chad. Thank you, and good luck to all of you. Our vocal music department, it's not a secret, it's the best department in the district of Dearborn. To showcase our program, I ask you to join me in enjoying the musical selection, You Raise Me Up, presented to us by the Edsel Ford Combined Vocal Ensemble and Concert Choir, led by our own Director of Choral Activities, Mr. Robert Doyle, and helped by John Horry.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Beautiful job. The class of 2011 has truly helped transform our building into a better place. I would like to recognize a very special group of students who helped in this transformation and who have worked so tirelessly for the last 4 years. Seniors, if you hear your name, please stand up and be recognized. And I ask the audience to please hold the applause until I recognize the entire group of students. First, I would like to start with the class president of 2011, Mr. Scott Worth, Vice President Samah Alatiri, Secretary Sean Sikkim, Treasurer Yasmin Shoman, Class Rep Ashley Alabawi, Class Rep Kathleen Peterson, Student Council Officer, President of the Student Council of Edsel Ford High School, Malik Hamoud, VP Vice President Fatima Hamadi, Secretary Alyssa Girardi, Treasurer Chelsea Rafsani Asi. Thank you, students, for leading us for the past 4 years and leading your class. Very nice job. Thank you. You may be seated. Now, class of 2011, again, your transformation over the past 4 years has been truly remarkable. We all recognize the hard work and dedication that you have positioned, that have positioned you to become Edsel Ford High School graduates. Today, this goal will become a reality. The time has come to confer this much-deserved honor to our graduating class. So, it is without any delay that I ask our counseling department to come forward and assist in the presentation of our diplomas to the class of 2011. Would the first group of graduates please rise?
I can do that.
They're going to start 30 coming our way.
Amr Hassan Abbas. Hannah Naji Abdullah. Sarah Muhammad Abdullah. Jeffrey T. Abdullah. Sammy Hassan Abdul Rab. Ali Abu Jamus. Jumana Ali Abu Salah. Ashley Nicole Adams. Mason Ajimi. Ferris Ahmed. Hamza Ahmed. Hussein M. Ahmed. Laila Ahmed. Ashley Alabawi. Ahmed Maki Alaboudi. Anas Alamar. Ali Alawadi. Zamzam Ali Alawi. Suhail Adnan Aldais. Saada Muhammad Al-Galhem. Bador Al-Haymi. Musad Al-Hajj. Akhlas Al-Harbi. Maha Ali. Mahmoud Ali. Mona Kasim Ali. Mona Sofyan Ali. Abdullah M. Al-Jahmi. Nuruddin Abu Al-Kahali.
Musa Abdal Alamuf. Jenna R. Allard. Wada Amadajhashi. Iman Al-Mansoub. Khalud Ali Al-Mawri. Amar Al-Mawri. Mohammed Salah Al-Riashi. Mohsen Al-Riashi. Norman Arbashi. Ahmed Fari Ashivani. Fatin Khaled Al-Shahati. Aziz Ahmed Al-Shahati.
Man, it's hot. It's hot.
Jimmy Al-Siufi.
The next dice box.
Sama Abdul Altari. Adam Alusi. Omar Sayel Amin. Vesakali Antonia Adu.
Vicky, it's Vicky.
Vicky. Bradley Ash. Abara Tariq Ashwader. May Abbas Askar. Hassam Qasem Ayub. Addison Claire Babinski. Brandon Beckert. Rasul Barhari. Brian Banks. Barber. Adam Munir Basha. Yusuf Bawaya.
All right.
Adam.
All right, thank you.
Hassan Bazzi. Hussein Shawi Bazzi. Rasha M. Bazoon. Warren Andrew Beach. Courtney Borden. Rebecca Marie Basque. Lindsay Morgan Boucher. Jenna Eileen Brackett. Jody Bradbury. Kyle Thomas Bridges. Bruce Brian Brown. Amelia Bruce. Lauren Burris. Hiba Karkora. Catherine M. Casillas. Ali Muhammad Shahroor. Alyssa Korn. Shane S. Kreitz. Ian Alexander Krosidig. Sarah Cunningham. Fadwa M. Dabaja. Ibrahim Darhan Darhan. Desiree Dwyer. Dwayne Dizon. Brendan Neil Driscoll. Kaylee A. Drzezinski. Devin James Dicio. Abdurrahman Iba. Ahmad Alanan.
Nasser Abgal. Joseph Mosva El Ghul. Rafat El Haj. Yusuf Abdel El Haj. Sarah Alamari.
Rafat, Rafat, you guys, come on. Come on.
Richard Emma. Brooke Lynn Enoch. Catherine Elizabeth Ensley.
Over here, over here. Good job, good job.
Stephanie Judith Estrada. Brandon Evans. Mohammed Washi Farhat. Omar Fatah. Jennifer Marie Ferrante. Afra Abdo Fatah. Carl William Fisher. Bassam Yahya Fatahi. Daniel John France. Mackenzie Brianne Frost. Elizabeth Gappa. Hosen Salah Jalan. Noor Hussam Ghanem. Monica Ann Gita. Alyssa Girardi. Ariel Jocelyn Glass. Parker Benjamin Glass. Nicole Marie Glowacki. Julian Goebel. Rachel Goschuk. Desmond Verone Granison. Andrea Greb.
Yeah, Andrea. Ooh, sticky. Once you stand up.
Andrew Green. Brittany Gunn. Ashraq Ahmed Hadara. Saab Haidar. Miranda Hall. Fatima Hamadi.
Aya Tariq Hamid. Malik Hamoud. Marwa Hamoud. Alexis Sandra Hancock. Curtis A. Hardison. Cody Robert Herring. Emily Hartshorn. Bethany Ann Hawkins. Craig Ryan Henderson. Logan Hendrock. Shelby Jean Holmes. Antoinette Marie Huffman. Ali Abdul Hussein. Angela Hussein. Faiza Abdullah Hussein. Tharar A. Hussein. Zachary Daniel Ingalls. Allison T. Ives. Chanel Jackson. Giovanna Johnson. Lauren Johnson. Christian Anthony Jordan. Ida Kaid.
Awesome. Samar M. Kadu. Michelle Jean Kerr. Naveen Ali Khalil. Omar Mohammed Khalil. Jack Richard Corrali. Brett Cook. Erica Cram. John Michael Kurlovich. Paige LaCasa. Joshua Allen Lamparski. Raquel June Latigo. Laura Rowena Laws. Megan Louie. Trevor Licht. Andrew Liu. Thomas Lobatos. Lucas Gary Lushanik. Dylan Charles Main. Brittany Major. Justin Malin. Frangiapani. Amel Morini. Andrew Joseph Mara. Nicole Marshall. Aaron Nicole Martinez. Hoda Ali Mari. Amber McCleary. Hayden Deloy McCade. McDade, excuse me.
Catherine McKenna. Charles Robert Malikian. Mary Mentor. Vincent Michael Mercado. Marissa Lynn Messing. Alina Louise Metis. Afaf Amin Mogali. Asha Mohammed. Amel Ahmed Mohammed. Hussein Salah Mohammed. Mohammed Mohammed. Muwafiq Mohammed. Wissam Mohammed. Yusuf Hassan Mohammed. Chelsea Ann Morris. Ryan William Morris. Jamila Mohammed Mothana. Sahar A. Mosup. Hanan Nabil Murshed. Shab Ahmed Musin. Jalal Musla. Khadija Abdul-Jan Nashal. Wasim Hassan Nasser. Ahmed Nasser. Musad Ahmed Nasser. Nasser Nasser. Robert Neff. Amanda Ray Nemeth. Berlin Quinn Nolan. Thank you.
Machiavelli. Faith Carolyn Ochoa. Nadia Omar. Alyssa Peck. Jordan Pelfrey. Devon Penson. Kathleen Peterson. Zacharias J. Patlikoff. Connor Allen Pettit. Pacharan Pachumchum. Pacha'a Pachumchum. Patrick J. Phillips. Chanel Hines. Morgan Sloan Pippin. Stephen Richard Pister. Frank Planka. Colette Elise Poisson. John Daniel Palanchin. Melanie Probst. Valerie Ann Purden. Ali Ali Kasim. Alicia Rebecca Ramirez. Chelsea Roya Rivasani. Lindsay L. Ravasani. Lindsay Reamer. Edward Reyes. Melissa M. Rice. Rich. Emily Lynn Richards. Christina Rippey. Rusco. Ali Ahmed Saidi. Raina M. Saif. Belkis A. Sala. Mohammed Saeed Sala Sala. Munther Ali Sala. Emily Marie Scott. Sean Paul Sackham. Fatima Saeed Shami. Alisa Shanahan. Cameron Michael Shane. Anissa Ali Sharif.
Hey.
Gada Sharif. Hanifa Sharif. Kanaf Sharif. Dennis and Shaco. Yasmin Showman. Jesse and Shoot. Kristen Elise Subic. Amanda Fatima Slayman. Derek Lamont Smith. Tyler Austin Smith. Rabia Sofian. Shakai Springer. Amanda Ray Stanek. Diane Stone. Pratish Thrash. Rhoda Abdallah Tulu.
Wall.
Waller. Nazreen K. Weeby. Pat M. Worth. Alexander West. Chad Westra. Brittany Wilkins. Kenneth Winder. Keith W. Wozniak. William Scott Reeford. Angela Diane Wizzola. Daniel James Wizzola. Sarah Yaffe. Kimberly Ann Zimmer. And Shelby Zimmerman.
How about another round of applause for our graduates? Congratulations. Yes. Determination, poise, and success. This is our creed at Edsel Ford High School. What a fine group of future leaders we have with us this evening. We are proud of you, your parents are proud of you, and the Dearborn community is proud of you. Now, I would like to ask all of us to join me in the singing of the Edsel Ford alma mater. The words could be found on the back cover of our program. To call upon Scott Worth, our current class president, to come forward for the presentation of the senior ceremony. He will be joined by our class of 2012 president, Alyssa Isaac.
It's been a tradition at Edsel Ford for many years of the traditional passing down of the gavel. Now, this gavel has been at Edsel Ford's holding for quite some time now, and every year the senior class president passes down the gavel to the junior class president. And on this gavel, it is written, "Keep your colors flying high." So that is what I say to you. Keep Edsel's colors flying high. Keep it the respectable school that it is. and take care of it while we're gone. Thank you.
Thank you, Scott. The class of 2012 promised to keep the traditions alive and allows Edsel to remain the best school in the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Alyssa. Graduates, please rise. This is the moment you have been waiting for, and on my signal, I'm going to ask you to move your tassel from right to left. One, two, three. Officially, I now declare you graduates of Edsel Ford High School. Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, please help me acknowledge Edsel Ford High School newest alumni group, the class of 2011. Now, I would like to ask the audience to please, please remain seated for our final recessional of the graduating class of 2011. Our graduates will be dismissed with the help of our marshals, Alyssa and Katie Beister, and the rest of us will meet up with them in the small gym by the small gym. So, at this point, we will start our recessional. Congratulations to the class of 2011, and thank you, parents. Thank you, everybody, for attending the class of 2011 graduation ceremony.